Hi. Whoa, she's glowing. Hi. I've got 15 minutes before I'm supposed to leave for town, and I thought I'd better get in because it's Friday and I'm so late, and I don't know why. I remember some days on Monday I thought I'll do it today, and then I'll be early, and I never got it done. And so, well, here we are, Friday. Anyway. And my darling daughter Kayla came around Wednesday while I was out and downloaded 5 gig worth of crap and used the last slither of my internet allowance. So it's going to take me days to upload this. So annoying. I gave her a big growly text and then told her off the next day. The worst thing is, she knows I don't like her downloading music and movies and things, and she still did it anyway. And I'd only just had a little bit of allowance left, and I was making it stretch. The worst thing is now I can't watch the original Amazing Race. I'm in series 8, in episode 8. That's what's really upsetting, to be honest. Oh, I should have checked the microphone, eh? Because if I do all of this and that's not working again, I will be annoyed. I don't even know how to do it. So, turning that one up. I don't know if that make any difference. We've somehow developed two microphones on, and when Skype comes on, sometimes you can hear it, sometimes you have to flick over the settings. And I'm guessing that's what happened last time, because I did it straight onto YouTube, recorded it to YouTube thing, and then there was it on camera, and oh gosh, and it was boring anyway. That when you ask for captions, it's like blah, caption would be blah blah blah, said with that much emotion too. Well, looks like Simon had a great time in Melbourne, and you had a great time with him in Melbourne, and Chop looked really good. It actually looks really professional, and that Easter Island head is a work of genius. I thought it was amazing. So, in flames, in flames. So good. I had to imagine it, just how I had to imagine the big pylon things that Tao showed us on the walkway in Melbourne, to imagine the flames coming out the top of these dark cylinders. So anyway, I'm starting now. I think I told you I was 3 months gluten-free. It's absolute crap. I'm not. I'm 6 months if I'm 6 weeks if I'm lucky. I don't know where that came from. I don't know. But today I'm supposed to be starting my lactose-free time. Not supposed to for any, like reason, medical or knowledgeable reason. It's just after 3 weeks of being lactose-free, I feel better. But look at my eyes. I've actually got makeup on today. They're still quite puffy and baggy, although they have been in. I've lost 6.5 kilos. Don't even know. So that's a bonus. And so I'm gonna try lactose free or lactose less, that's what I'm calling it. Gluten less and lactose less. And I talked to this lady yesterday, Mum introduced me to, who's lost 50 something kilos, but she found out even after losing it that she had all these allergies and stuff, and that's why she was tired all the time. So I was like, crap, she's allergic to everything. Bananas, she can't eat sugar. I mean, what's there left to eat if you can't eat bread, sugar, bananas? And who's allergic to bananas? And so now when I eat a banana, I feel sick, and I'm like, I'm allergic to bananas. It's taken me a day and I caught it. So anyway, we're gonna see what having less milk. I'm gonna have a lot of milk, really. Really. I have cheese and yogurt, which apparently is all right. Anyway, the hunt for less black eyes. You're gonna say they look better, but they actually, that's all the caked in concealer. And wearing my gym clothes because I'm off to the gym this afternoon. I've been going, went to spin class. Oh my goodness, I've avoided that all my life. Well, since spin got invented, because of fear. And I made friends go with me, and I was I had an upset tummy in the morning. I was so nervous about it. When they close the doors are clang close and lock. They lock you in, and then you're trapped, and then they tie you to the bike, and you can't get off, and it's just awful. And within a minute, wouldn't have maybe even been that long, my bum started hurting. So the whole time everyone's like, my legs, and I'm like, my bum, my bum, my bum. And so get off it, and it's like the last thing I want to do is sit back on one of those seats. I've been looking on TradeMe to find gel seats. Yes. And I don't fit, because everyone like stretch out to the handlebars, but I had to hold the thing on the front of the handlebars, and everything was like pushed to smallest in. And am I that? Am I really that short and I just don't know it? Maybe I am. Okay.